Alright, well, this is clearly not my style. Anyways, what's up, guys? And today, I'm gonna be doing something different. Since, basically, Noah represents me, Total Drama Characters represent my, me and my friends, my channel's kinda Total Drama. I haven't really done any Total Drama videos, so I'm gonna be making a Total Drama Island my way, because I was thinking to do something different, because I've only been doing gaming videos for the past like 2 years, but I'm doing no script, because I'm an OCD fucko, so I'm gonna keep writing the script for hours, and that's wasting my time. So I don't want my OCD to kick in. So anyways, who's gonna be going right into this? So episode one, no one gets eliminated. Alright, episode two. Basically nothing changes. The killer bass lose. Ezekiel's a dumbass and says a sexist comment and he gets eliminated. Pretty simple. Now, episode 3 is different. Killer Bass still lose, but instead of Heather fucking Eva over, not in that way, Katie and she tries to drive a wedge between Katie and Sadie throughout the episode. And this makes them fight, and it starts annoying the team as fuck, and they put one of them out. In my opinion, it doesn't really matter which one, one of them's going out, and it's going to be Sadie, mainly because I just like Katie better. And it was episode 4, Dodge Brawl. Alright, now, not much of it changes. The only thing that will be changing is that Noah and Heather, Noah and Justin do not participate in the challenge, but Noah goes to Heather and knows about the alliance between these three and goes to them, and he's friends with Owen. No, definitely not. So these five vote for Justin. These five vote for Justin. Justin's able to convince Trent, Gwen, and Lashana to vote with him to vote Noah off. Owen convinces Izzy to join them. And it doesn't really matter who Cody votes. Let's just say he votes with Justin because he wants to be with Gwen, but 6-5. So Justin's out of here. And we've got to move the Killer Bass up. Anyways, episode 5, Not Quite Famous. So, the acts are basically the same. Courtney was gonna go up, but Bridget broke with Ireland, people going up as Harold, DJ, and... You know what, let's put Eva up. We'll put Eva up, she's gonna do some good shit. Anyways, and Heather goes up. Reads Gwen's diary. Noah decides to go up, and so does Trent. Since Justin ain't here, Noah's gonna go up. And Noah and Heather actually start an alliance in episode 4, but Noah breaks it after seeing what kind of Noah's a dick, but he doesn't like that. He's not that douchey, so. He breaks the alliance with Heather, and Heather sabotages his talent, and he ends up breaking the entire stage, and Chris disqualifies Noah. But Noah was mostly gonna get voted out anyways, so Noah's out. Big sad favorite character. Anyways, the sucky outdoors. Yes, okay, so sorry. So the killer boss win because Owen and Izzy draw a bell over to the camp, and they just can't leave. The bell's in the way. And between Owen and Izzy, they voted Izzy. Alright. Anyways, next is episode 7, Phobia Factor. So, the killer bass loose. And, it's pretty straightforward. Instead of Courtney failing her field, she completes it with the help of Duncan. Duncan will pay in the fable. And Katie's is the one with 12 points that she fails out of here. Also, Eva was close to getting eliminated because she doesn't have a feel. So yeah, she was close to getting eliminated just for not getting a point for having no feel. And it was episode 8, Up the Creek. The Screaming Gophers win, and I think it's pretty obvious between these 8, Eva's going home, mainly because in a fit of rage caused by probably Duncan, honestly. I'd say Duncan would get pretty pissed at her. And she breaks the boats and the oars. And yeah, she gets eliminated. So episode 9. Just double checking. I did do a fucking page of who's getting eliminated, so I need double check those. Alright, there we go. Okay, so the exact same thing happens. Beth stands up to Heather in the challenge, and also the Screaming Gophers lose. And instead of Cody getting mauled by a bell, no one gets mauled by a bell, and Beth just gets eliminated. Out of here, gone. Alright, episode 10. If you can't take the heat, pretty obvious what's happening here. What is it called? The Killer Bass win, and since Beth ain't here with the Tiki doll, I'm just gonna say that the black plot never existed, because it doesn't need to happen, because that plot only happened to save Heather's ass and Owen's. So, Owen eats all the food, dumbass, gets eliminated. Alright, episode 11, Who Can You Trust? So, with this challenge is that the killer bass do win. DJ doesn't lift his blindfold up this time, but Cody and Gwen go on the final challenge, and Cody like actually does something right with Gwen, but she lifts her blindfold up, and yeah, people blame Cody for him technically doing that, and he gets eliminated. But Gwen doesn't vote. These four vote Cody off, but Gwen votes with Cody and vote Heather off. So that's a little Cody and Gwen development. Anyways, episode 12, basic training, but the exact same thing happens. Killer Bass lose. Then Harold and Courtney, and Courtney gets eliminated. Harold, you bitch, rigging the votes. But I respect it. Episode 13, the exact same thing happens. But only, instead of DJ jumping off the plane, it's Tyler. It's gonna be hilarious. And, yeah, Harold just gets eliminated. It's pretty obvious. Alright, oh wait, hold on. I'm clicking the wrong one. Okay. Now, episode 14 was the biggest missed opportunity ever. I feel like this should have been a challenge for the eliminated contestants to be in. So I'm just gonna bring them all up real quick. Let's hope I remember this. So slow and steady. Alrighty, so they compete in 3 different challenges, and there's 12 of them. So in the first challenge, 4 people get eliminated. It is basically the brunch of disgustingness, but only it's turned it into a Eternals challenge. So it's basically an eating challenge. Like, oh no. Okay, anyways, yeah, so the people who pass is Owen, Izzy, this ain't in any particular order because I'd be here all day. Harold, Courtney, Cody, definitely Eva, definitely not you two. Zeke would pass, Cody would pass, and I say Noah would pass. I feel like him and Justin will be fighting, but I think he would just pass. Also, sorry if you're noise in the background, my pounce. Anyways, yeah, I think Noah and Justin will be fighting the entirety of the first round, but Justin won't eat any of his food because he doesn't want his board to be ruined, so Noah would just get through last before Beth. Because Katie and Sadie would be fighting, Justin would not be eating it, and Beth would be eating it, but just Noah passes just about. So go back to where you came from. Go back to your episodes. Depending on if I can remember which ones you guys were. Alright, there we go. Alright, so the next round is more disgusting food. So Owen makes it through. I say Courtney would make it through, not Courtney. Now, I think Courtney sabotages Eva, and Eva just fails. Oh, sorry, not Courtney. Noah, because Noah's here to win now. And Noah finishes. Because he wants him and Owen to rejoin. And between these four, Izzy finishes, and these four get eliminated for good. So, Harold, go back there. Ezekiel, go back to the first boot. Anyways, we are down to the final four. Only two of these people are rejoining. Who will it be? So Courtney and Noah, so basically Courtney and Noah start to get into a fight. Noah, you fucking with everyone now. And Owen kind of, and Izzy kind of just eat their food. So like, these two get eliminated, just out of here. Yeah. And Owen and Izzy rejoin, and I just noticed I didn't make a merge button. So, and I changed, hold up, let me. Everything's going wrong now. Alright. Merge. Everyone, you get in now. So, we are now officially in the merge. So, we can say goodbye to the teams. And we can just delete these. And yeah. Alright, so episode 15. Alright, so it's a bit different because Eva is not here. So, and also, what is it called? Tyler's here now. Tyler's not here now. Oh, Tyler's here now. Instead of Eva. But anyways, I think 15 should have been a purge challenge, in my opinion. And the person who loses the purge challenge would be DJ, in my opinion. In my opinion, he was the odd one out in the merge. He was the only one who kind of stood out to me. So I'd say 15 is a good enough episode there. Episode 16, okay, the exact same thing happens. Basically, Heather and Lindsay. Heather kisses Trent, makes Gwen pissy. Oh, we are Gwen pissy. Heather fucking wins that diamond immunity, you lucky bitch. And everyone votes Trent off. Sadness. Anyways, episode 17, hide and be sneaky. Alright, now so the people who actually win immunity is Heather for snitching, Lashana for actually winning. Lindsay wins immunity because Heather decided to share the immunity with Lindsay by getting one each. And Duncan gets immunity for snitching on Tyler. Because why not? Anyways, this is around where the Boys Alliance gets made. But only Duncan comes over with the boys. Anyways, yeah. He comes over with the boys, except for Tylo, and he wants to get Tylo eliminated. And Heather agrees. So, but Lindsay doesn't agree and votes, and there's a vote going on for, to get, not Heather, she's immune, to get Izzy out. So people, so Heather tells Izzy about it, she votes with them, and a tie is in order between Tylo and Izzy. And also the reason people want to vote, definitely wants to vote Tylo off is mainly because he kept fucking around the entire challenge and like getting most of the people out. So it's just about a tiebreaker, and Tylo loses and gets eliminated, which makes Lindsay sad. But anyway, that's off the chain. The exact same thing happens. Bullshit to me, but Lindsay gets eliminated due to BS. Situations. Anyways, episode 19, hook, line, sink, the screamo. Alright, so this was a purge challenge in the original, which I'm still gonna keep. Now, I'm giving the immunity to Duncan and Gwen, because I do think both of them deserve the immunity, in my opinion. But it's still a purge challenge, so instead of the person who got scared the most, the person who fucking, because if it's the person who got scared the most, it'd be Owen out of here. But the person who got caught first was Jeff. Bridget got caught second because she ran away, but Jeff got caught first, so Jeff's out of here. Anyways, episode 20, Wawanakwa has gone wild. Alright, so the exact same thing happens here, but only Jeff replaces, or Bridget replaces Jeff, and she's crying her eyes out, and her friend, and LaShawn and Gwen's consoling her, being good friends, because I feel like this would be a good friend trio. Anyways, Izzy shoots Heather with the tranquilizer dart, and yeah, Heather, and then she just goes on a wild spree shooting everyone with tranquilizer darts. That's the only different part. That's the reason people vote her instead of, Heather. So yeah, everyone gets shot with tranquilizer darts, except for Owen, because then he's with the end. So it's a 2-5 for Heather and Izzy. Anyways, episode 21, Trial by Armed Triathlon. So the teams are going to be... I didn't actually think of this. It's going to be Bridget and Duncan, Heather and Owen, and LaShawn and Gwen. Now, the big one of immunity is LaShawn and Gwen. It's pretty obvious. They're the only duo that would actually work here. And Duncan and Bridget get some development, because Duncan wasn't too fond of Bridget, but now he understands, and they're like kind of friends, good friends. And Bridget tells him like, you don't have to act bad and stuff to make people like you, you know. So these two vote for Heather, and there's bullshit reason that Jeff got voted out means Bridget gets out. Even though these two would never vote these two, it's a bullshit reason, I know. But we kind of need Bridget out here. So anyways, this is the episode that LaShawn got fucked, which is the exact same thing that's happening. I know. It sucks. But anyways, yeah. Episode 23 is a non-elimination. It's a non-elimination. And it's episode 24, the exact same thing happens. Duncan and Owen get paired, and Gwen and Heather get paired. Gwen and Heather won immunity. But instead, of Duncan getting eliminated, Owen gets eliminated. Mainly because the fucking Owen, three, my thing, I don't know why Chef eliminated Owen though. And like, I don't know why, no, he eliminated Duncan. Well, I don't know why he eliminated Duncan after Owen ruined his entire day. I think Chef was still mad about episode 12. Anyways, episode 25, I Triple Dog Dare You. So Duncan starts winning all these freebies because he ain't giving two shits about any of these dares. And he splits them with Gwen, and then Heather gets tortured. Hilarious. Gets her hair cut off. Eliminated. And now we are in the finale. So we can delete that. And yeah, hold up. Trent roots for Gwen. Oh, Trent's helping Gwen through the entire way, and Courtney is helping Duncan through the entire way. And in my personal opinion, I think Gwen would win in my way, but obviously both of them won, so it could go either way. But yeah, I think either of them would win. But in my personal opinion, I think Gwen would win. If there was only one winner. So sorry, Duncan, you're getting second. So yeah, that is my personal opinion of how Total Drama Island should have gone down. If you think anything should have gone differently, you can comment down below. I think it's a pretty good my way, because a lot of people do my ways by how much they like a character. Like, I remember seeing a my way of Gwen getting eliminated set of heel, and I am not joking, there was a my way for that. Gwen got first boot. That guy must have really hated Gwen. But anyways, yeah. What do you think of my way? Honestly, I think it's a pretty good my way, and I'm probably gonna be doing the entire series, maybe even some fan made my ways. But we'll see. So I hope you all enjoyed my Total Drama Island my way. I'm gonna be doing Total Drama Action soon, and I also don't really need to edit this. Yes. So when I feel like I don't want to edit, just do one of these videos.